Welcome to this presentation on similarity search of an enriched geospatial data. I'm Kostas Patroumbas, and this is a joint work with Dimitris Koutas at Athena Research Center in Greece in the context of the Smart Data Lake project. We consider enriched geospatial data, for example, points of interest regarding companies or tourist attractions, that apart from their location include other types of attributes like textual, keywords defining the industrial sector of the company, or numerical ones with information about the revenue or the number of employees in the company, and perhaps temporal ones with dates and timestamps important in the company's life cycle. Our concern is to answer similarity search queries involving multiple attributes, not just the spatial ones, but also the textual, numerical, or temporal ones. For instance, consider this query that wants to find companies located in or near Portland that deal with software and technology, these are the keywords, and have an annual revenue of around $300,000. If we consider just the location, then those two companies are the answer to our query. But if the numerical attribute only is taken into consideration, we get a different answer. But if we consider just the textual attribute, then we get a different answer based on the matching keywords with those specified in the query. But our objective is different. We want to find the top K results for our similarity search based on aggregated scores across all the examined attributes, and the answer may differ from the previous ones. What can we do in order to provide response to such similarity search queries? Well, if the data resides in the DBMS, then we could specify an SQL query involving all the attributes. But the difficulty is how to express the various criteria and the conjunction between them. For instance, what is the numerical range of interest, since similarity search is not natively supported in DBMS? And concerning the spatial attribute, what is the suitable distance range that we want to search in order to find qualifying candidates? And if all this were magically resolved somehow, how to order the results and get the final rankings? If the data is on the web, then you could do keyword search. The difficult part, again, is to specify suitable keywords for this search. But you shouldn't bet that you could get meaningful results unless you are feeling very, very, very lucky. Next, we will give you an overview of our work towards addressing multi-attribute similarity search over enriched geospatial entities. Note that different similarity measures may be applied per attribute. Jacquard similarity for keywords, Euclidean distances for locations, and so on. And perhaps apply different weight parameters per attribute in order to calibrate the final rankings. We treat this problem as a rank aggregation problem in two steps. The first one is to run individual KNN queries per attribute and get a rank list of qualifying entities per attribute. This enables us to run these queries in parallel, flexibly support any number of type of attributes, and also calibrate and configure per attribute, the similarity measure, the query execution algorithm, and the index support. The second step is to get the candidates from those individual lists, aggregate them, and yield the final results. We examine two challenging issues in this work. The first one concerns the overall scoring of the candidate entities. Since each queried attribute specifies its own similarity measure, the scores it yields are expressed perhaps in different units. Therefore, we need to scale those scores in order to aggregate them and yield the final rankings. Besides, we should not consider that all data is available in a single site. In fact, data per attribute may be available in disparate, remote, or heterogeneous sources. So we have to query each one of them, fetch the results, and then do the rank aggregation. In fact, some rank aggregation methods rely on random access to the data, so they have to retrieve attribute values for entities on demand and calculate exact scores. But what can you do if random access is costly or limited or even not allowed by the data sources? Then we should adapt the rank aggregation methods and perhaps even tolerate approximate rankings if exact scores are not possible. The problem and the various concepts are formally explained in the paper. Here, instead, we will give an example assuming three attributes of different types in order to explain the processing flow of our method. The first step is for each attribute to build an index. Inverted index for keywords, B+tree index for numerical values, and an R-tree for spatial locations. Against each index, we specify a query using the similarity criterion pertinent to that attribute. Of course, these queries can run in parallel and yield each one of them a separate ranked list of candidates. Each such list should contain enough candidates, many more than the desired k entities, in order to be able to find matching items between those different collections during rank aggregation. In fact, rank aggregation gets the results of those ranked lists with applying different weights, and after combining those scores, it provides the final aggregate top k results. Let's take a closer look on how we do the scaling of scores. These are the contents of the ranked lists for our query example regarding companies in Portland. As you can see, the distances per attribute are expressed in different units. Jacquard distance for keywords, currency for revenue, and kilometers regarding distance from the query location. To make them comparable, we select as scaling factor the distance of the kth value in each such ranked list. And then we convert each absolute distance into a relative one, separately for each list. Then we use those relative values in an exponential decay function with suitable parameter lambda as a decay factor in order to provide the final ranking scores in the range between 0 and 1. The ranked lists are limited in size, up to 6 elements in this particular example here, and do not contain all the attribute data ranked by each similarity criterion per attribute. Given that, how can we combine their contents in order to get aggregate scores and issue the top k final results? Well, this is a well-known problem in the literature. It's called rank aggregation, and in our paper we make use of two such methods. The first one is called threshold algorithm and is based on random access to the data in order to get attribute values and compute exact scores. Note that this assumes that it has access to all the data and not just the limited amount of items available in the ranked lists. Anyway, assuming unrestricted access to all the data, the algorithm iterates over each ranked list in parallel and calculates a threshold value. In this case, this is the sum of the scores of the currently seen entities in this iteration. For each entity seen in this iteration, it accesses randomly the other lists and fetches the missing attribute values in order to compute its actual exact score. And finally, it maintains the top k scores in a separate queue. Once an item in this queue has an exact score that is above the current threshold, then the algorithm guarantees that this can be issued as the next result and finally terminates once all top k results have been returned. Another well-known method applies no random access. As it iterates through the contents of the ranked lists in parallel, and it cannot compute the exact scores for the seen entities, it calculates upper and lower bounds on the aggregated scores based on the values seen so far. The main concern in this method is that these bounds need to be updated in every iteration, and this might have a prohibitive computational cost. In this particular example, we exhaust all the lists in order to issue all the top k results. A top k result can be issued once its lower bound is above the maximum upper bound of any of the other entities seen so far. Note that sometimes results may be issued with no exact scores, but with score bounds instead. Since the threshold algorithm may not be applicable in case that random access to the entire dataset is not possible, and also as the no random access may need to perform too many iterations in the ranked lists, here we suggest another variant. This is called partial random access, and as the name implies, it restricts random access only to the contents of the ranked lists. Some entities may not appear in all lists, so no exact scores can be computed for them. That's why we maintain upper and lower bounds for their scores. We also calculate the average of those bounds in order to sort these bound intervals. The next top k result is issued once its lower bound is above the current threshold and also above the maximum average bound of the remaining seen entities. Contrary to the bounds in the no random access method, the bounds here in partial random access do not change for any seen entity in every iteration. We only compute bounds for new unseen entities. To evaluate our approach, we conducted experiments against a real-world dataset containing 15 million news articles extracted from the JITLED project. Each entity includes several types of attributes. As a query workload, we randomly choose 100 entities from the dataset. We measured performance in terms of average query response time for the three ranking methods, and we also specified a timeout limit of 60 seconds. A query was suspended if it did not provide results by then. Regarding quality, we measured the normalized discounted cumulative gain. This is a measure widely used in information retrieval that indicates that items with higher relevance should appear earlier in the top k results. This can be computed based on the aggregated scores we received for the top k items, and it can be normalized with the ideal ranking provided by the threshold algorithm. Since this is the only method that provides accurate results thanks to exact score computation. Regarding the performance results, these plots show the average query response time for different list sizes m. As you can see, no random access is generally not affordable when k is increasing. And in fact, many queries with an array fail to complete due to timeout. Instead, the threshold algorithm is very, very fast, provided, of course, that we have complete access to all the data. If this is not the case and we have to rely only to the contents of the ranked lists, then partial random access provides a good alternative with acceptable performance. With respect to quality, of course, the threshold algorithm is the best as it provides accurate results, thanks to random access. But if partial random access is applied, then we can get a fairly good quality of results, often with more than 80% relevance to the accurate ones. Instead, no random access has a quality that deteriorates when k takes values more than 10, because many queries time out before completion. We have also performed tests against varying sets of attributes. In terms of performance, it appears that partial random access is competitive to the threshold algorithm. Instead, no random access is not affordable even when queries involve very few attributes. In terms of quality, partial random access is, of course, less accurate than the threshold algorithm, but note that its results can be issued almost as fast. To summarize, in this work, we have dealt with the problem of similarity search over enriched geospatial entities involving multiple attributes of different types, and we have treated it as a rank aggregation problem. Our ongoing work concerns automatically tuning the size of the ranked list per attribute as a trade-off between ranking quality and efficiency, and also enabling in situ KNN processing against database systems and REST APIs. You can get more information from our website and updates of our open source code from our repository. Many thanks for your interest.